Children, in the last class, we were discussing about the EVS chapter, that is amazing energy. In that, we have come across the different type of energy. We have seen some five types of the energies. That is, the first is electrical energy, muscular energy, mechanical energy, wind energy, solar energy. Now, we will go with the stored energy of water. What is the stored energy of the water? We know that the water flows from the higher order to the lower positions, and that is called as the potential energy, the flowing of the water from the higher positions to the lower positions. As you can see here, this is the dam reservoirs, right? What will happen here? The water is flowing from the higher to lower, and this water is stored and it is allowed to move all over the ponds, rivers, etc. And here what will happen, due to the force exerted by the running water, the turbines are rotated fast. Okay, here you can see, this is the system of the turbine. What they will do? They will keep here electrical plates or the steel plates. And when the water started flown on it, and the water from the higher level falls on the turbines, the turbine will start rotating and it will produce the electricity. And this electricity is called as the hydroelectric power generating stations. So here is one activity, that is, write the names of the dams you know, put right mark on the one of you have visited. And most nearer to us is the Tungabhadra Dam, again Alamatti Dam, Nagarjuna Dam, Sardar Sarovara Dam, Tehri Dam and Bakran Angle Dam. So these are the some few dams, and we have visited, obviously we will be visiting Tungabhadra Dam because it is very near to us. Next, here is one another activity, that is near the hydroelectric power generation stations in the Karnataka. That is the electrical power generation stations in the Karnataka. In Karnataka, it is in Kudasalli Dam, Supa Dam and MGHE2 Dam. So these three dams produce hydroelectric city. And here are some other dams also, Ipati Dam, Guri Dam and Gorges Dam. So these are the dams that produces the hydroelectric powers. Now, name the works which can be done by using water energy. What are the works that can be done using water energy? We can produce electricity, that is normal electricity, by running that we can use, and also hydroelectric by the dam. It means that hydroelectricity, as we know, by rotating the turbines, we can naturally produce the electrical energy. Naturally, water is a very precious thing and it is available all over. And the electricity which produced with the more effect and expense should also be used moderately. And the energy should be conserved, because electricity is need of everyone. And if we produce the electricity with the help of this water reservoirs, what will happen? We will use less amount for producing this electricity. So now here are some other activities, that is, right, two situations where we can save electricity. What we should do? We should unplug all the televisions at the night time or the computers that we are using, and also we should turn off all the fans and the light if we are not in the room or in the classrooms. By doing this, what we will do? We will save some point of the electrical energy. Next energy is electrical energy. Nowadays we are using so much of the electrical appliances. For example, electrical heater, electrical cooker, iron box, fans, televisions, lights, everything is depend upon the electricity only. And here are some activities, that is, write any four work done using the electrical appliances in your home. First is electrical appliances, and then is work done. Heater, what we will do? Electrical heater, with the help of the electrical heater, we will heat the water. Iron box, we use electricity and we heat the iron box, and we will use it for the ironing of the cloth. Refrigerator, for cooling the vegetables and keeping them fresh. televisions. We use it for the entertainment purpose. And for example, we use computers also for storing the data and also for our use. Here, electrical appliances, they have given here. What we will do, we will use the electricity to use this kind of the appliances. And next, energy is bioenergy. The gas produced by the degraded agricultural waste, for example, sugarcane waste or the cow dung waste. What we will do, we will produce by the cow dung waste and the sugarcane waste. We will produce a gas. That gas is known as the biogas, and we will produce it in the absence of the air. So it is called as the biogas. It is used for cooking. The energy is available from the biogas can be converted into electrical energy, and also many form of the work can be done. If we produce it in the electrical energy is used for so many kind of the work. Here, write here the work you know that can be done using the bioenergy. Bioenergy, what we will do? Biodiesel and ethanol fuel to the fuel of the vehicle. We can use the biodiesel for the fuel of the vehicles. Methane gas and the wood to generate electricity. Geothermal gas and biomass is used to generate electricity. So these are all the things that we can do with the help of the biogas. Then the bioenergy obtained from the agricultural waste help the human being to maintain healthy environment. Because by the use of the petrols, we are getting so many pollution problems. But nowadays, if we use the biogas system, we will have the healthy environment. Next, we will go with the ninth, that is chemical energy. Chemical energy is produced by the chemical reactions that takes place in the substance. For example, electrical cell, as you can see here. What will happen in the electrical cell? It provides the electricity with the help of the charges. That is, as you can see here, positive and negative charges. When we connect two wires to it, it will flow, it will allow the electricity to pass through it and the bulb will glow. So this energy is called as the chemical energy. Next is the fuel energy. Fuel, so many kind of the fuels we have seen. Kerosene, petroleum, LPG, these are all the fuels only. One more energy is available in nature, that is fuel energy. Fuel energy, it is the natural source of energy and it is combustible. And it can be used to produce heat and also the light energy. And it can be converted into electrical energy, mechanical energy, etc. Here the pictures are given. As you can see, they have asked that which fuel is used to burn these objects. Okay, here you can see kerosene, wood, firewood, LPG, petrol, diesel, jet fuel, and here rocket, it uses the green fuel and it consisting of the methane, liquid and oxygen, that is the chemicals that are used. And here in the ship, they use heavy fuel oil or the bunker fuels. And here is one another activity, that is, if you have appliances which make use of the fuel in your home, write down below. I have noted someone, that is LPG gas that we use and the water heater that we use and also the fire pits that we use. And we use petrol for the vehicles to run. You can write some other things also that you use. Firewood is also a fuel. Burning of the firewood gives the heat. By using this heat energy, it is possible to cook and do other works. Okay, firewood is also a fuel. Because with the help of it, what we will produce? We will produce the heat energy. Fuel is the natural source and it is moderate to protect our environment. Solar energy must be used more instead of the conventional fuels. Okay, solar energy is used everywhere because conventional fuels are not been produced as much as we need. So solar energy is the best source of energy and it is a natural source of energy. Energy is available in different forms. And it is, solar energy is the natural form of the energy. Here is the activity, write down the different forms of energy that you know. Okay, what we have seen the thermal energy, nuclear energy, sound energy, gravitational energy, water energy, chemical energy, motion energy, elastic energy, electrical energy, heat energy. We have seen this kind of the energies. What will happen in the water energy? We produce electricity. With the heat energy, we can produce electricity and we can cook the food also. Heat energy is converted into different form of energy. Chemical energy, motion energy is also converted into different form of energy. Okay, changes of energy from one form to another. Energy is changed from one form to another. And the energy available like sun, water, wind, food, chemical reactions are present in the nature. And also fuel, for example, fuel energy is converted into mechanical energy to run the vehicle. We put the petrol to run the bikes. Here is one activity, that is running of the petrol car from form of the energy and the form of the change. What it will change? It will change from chemical energy to the mechanical energy. Drum playing. Drum playing, what we will do? We will beat the drum like. So, it is the form of energy, that is muscular energy to sound energy. So, here are the different type of energy that changes from one form to another form. Now, here we have learned, write the other example for the change of the energy from one form to another. We have seen that is heat energy to the light energy. For example, if we burn the firewood, it will create the light. So heat energy is converted into light energy. Chemical energy to the mechanical energy. We can see in the running of the petrol car. We use car, petrol, diesel. What we will do? We will run vehicles from one place to another. For that reason, what we will do? We will use the fuels. So we will run chemical. We will change chemical energy into mechanical energy, electrical energy into kinetic energy. That is, we use fans, televisions, everything. So what will happen if we on the switch of the fan? It will rotate. So here it is the kinetic energy, electrical energy to heat energy. For example, iron box we use, and what will happen there? We will heat the iron. To iron the cloth. What will happen with the help of the electricity? The iron box get heated. Conversions of the energy. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be converted from one form of the energy to other form. Energy remains in one or other form. Means energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. We can destroy any energy, right? We can convert it into one form of energy to the another forms. Here is one activity. Traveling by the bicycle, what we save the fuel energy. Washing the clothes by hand, we save chemical and also the electrical energy because we use washing machines to wash the clothes. Producing electricity from the wind, we save electrical energy. Cooking food using the biogas, we say fuel, LPGs. Not to put on the radio when there is no electricity. We must save electricity at that time also. So here is the last part, that is which alternative energy can be used instead of the conventional energy. See here, alternative energy used. Here are some alternative energies they have given. Instead of using the heater. Heater is nothing but using the firewood. Okay, without using the firewood, we can use solar water heater and also the biogas system, that is natural. Electrical geyser, we can use solar water heater. Solar energy is the natural source of energy. Cooking rice on the hearth, solar cooker we can use. Electrical bulb, solar cells we can use. listening to the radio by using the electricity. Solar cells we use because radio is on only with the help of the electrical cells, that is solar cells. While doing the work, one can use the alternative energy using solar energy instead of the electrical or the fuel energy. So, energy fulfills our all the essential needs of our living beings. Energy is gained by our body by the help of the food. What we eat the food, it will help our energy and also environment. Or the other activities carefully, because we should, in the sake of ourselves, we should not harm any kind of the environment. So, I hope you have understood it. Thank you all.